everybody, welcome back to my channel. This is Belinda at My Style Journey. I've been in a little bit of a quandary over the last few days. So let me give you a little bit of a backstory. We put our house on the market in March this year. The markets were very slow, and up until June, I think due to the hard lockdown that we experienced, possibly all over the world, but definitely here in South Africa, we had no clients looking at our house until June. From June till September, we had a multitude of people coming in and out of our house. Now, very recently, my daughter and her daughter, who's my three-year-old granddaughter, were living at home. And anyone who has little children living in the house will know that it is so difficult to keep a home clean when you're living with a toddler. And I just think that it was a very, very stressful time for most of the parts. My little granddaughter was at home. She went back to school, I think it was the 1st of September. So up until then, she was at home and we had to deal with people coming in to the house and the house not looking like a show house, which of course it isn't. It's not my expectation that it should look like that, but we do live in a more upmarket area where it really does count what your house looks like at any given time of the day. But it was very stressful to show the house and having to clean it because we have a very large home, large by our standards in any case, to keep it clean. So I'm telling you this whole long story to finally tell you that we have sold our house. We had a couple that was interested in September, but unfortunately for us, they weren't prepared to pay full price. We had already dropped our price by quite a large amount, so we weren't prepared to accept their offer. They then upped their offer slightly, but it was still below our new asking price. Within 2 days, we had somebody who came and looked at the house and paid full asking price. And that isn't the full price that we originally wanted, but the reduced price. They were prepared to pay that. So we signed, and fortunately my husband gave them a 3-week period in which to get finance for their home. Unfortunately for us, they weren't from South Africa. Different rules apply when applying for a loan from the bank if you're not a South African, and the loan wasn't approved. So we went back to the original buyers who had offered us even less. And we do love this couple. We believe that they will be happy in our home. We believe that they will love our home as much as we do. So my energy has definitely been all over the place. Not only has COVID done something to the inside of me where there's a lot of uncertainty, and I'm sure with most of us that is the case, but I have definitely felt that I wanted to go to Underberg, which is where we will be moving. It's a place in the southern Drakensberg in South Africa. Do look it up if you're not South African. It is a gorgeous, gorgeous part of the world. And we've been wanting to go there for the past 4 years. We always said that we would definitely retire there. We are now going to be calling that our home. So we are excited on that front. But on the other hand, we haven't found a home yet. So I'll give you a little bit of background on that little dilemma. We found a home. We sent a photograph to a friend who had also gone looking at homes in the same area a week before, and she said to me, did the agent tell you that the property next door was going to be rezoned for commercial? Now, we were already, the property was already backed up on a commercial property, which I wasn't happy about, but because of the size of the property, it's on an acre. And the house being built in the middle, I didn't think that the commercial property at the back would play a major role in our everyday life. But hearing that the house next door was going to be knocked down and made into a commercial property, that hugely impacted our decision. So we contacted the agent and we withdrew our offer. Fortunately, we hadn't signed anything. And long story short, we lost that home. Having said all of that, there was a property that the agent took us to. She called it our wild card property because it didn't tick all our boxes. But when we entered the actual house, there was a flat on the premises and there was somebody living in the flat. But when we went into the house is move-in ready. There are 2 bathrooms, 3 bedrooms, open plan lounge, dining room and kitchen. The kitchen is brand new and it's exactly what I love. There is a strip on the front, a veranda, and it has the potential of being extended and closed in to provide an extra room, like a sunroom, that we wanted to do at a later stage. There was unfortunately only a single garage on the property. We would definitely need a double. There was a double carport, and in the area where the carport was, there's potential to actually build a double garage, and my husband saw chance to do that. He also does a lot of woodwork projects. So he was looking for a bit of a workshop, and we decided that we would build a double garage with a workshop at the back, and he would have his space where he would be able to potter around and do some projects. We spoke to the agent this morning and the seller now is in a dilemma because there's somebody living in the flatlet. It's family of the seller and he doesn't know what he's going to be doing with her. It's his sister and she's a single mum. So what we've done now is that we've offered for her to stay there at a very low rent until the end of June next year. So for the foreseeable future, we will not be able to do anything with the flatlets, but that is okay. We're okay to live with that. But we only have until tomorrow for the seller to come up with a yay or a nay. So at the moment, my heart is sore. I'm not feeling that we are going to get it. This is just what the process is. That's what I keep telling myself. It just feels like every house that we look at, there's an issue attached. And I know that it has to do with the price that we have to offer, because we bought our current home for a very low price, and in the 10 years that we've lived here, our home has doubled in value, and we didn't want to buy for more than the profit on our home. We don't want to buy with a bond. We don't want to have a mortgage. I don't want to waste any more time being negative. I think you can feel that my heart is a little bit sore, but I think anybody who is buying a property, these are the things that you go through. There's ups and there's downs, and that is just par the course, and we just have to ride this out until we find the property that works best for us. And we will find it. It has to be there. Our home is waiting for us. I just want to put a little insert here and ask that if you're not already subscribed to this channel, would you consider hitting the subscribe button? I would love it if you commented on the video. I love to read comments and I love to interact with each one of you. So today I just thought I would talk a little bit about how my wardrobe is going to change if I move to Underberg. We were there for 2 to 3 days last week, and it had rained a little overnight on one of the nights. It was very hot the one day when we arrived, and it was coolish the next day, and it was really cold the next day. So it's going to be an adjustment for both my husband and I, who come from a very hot area. If I can explain about our temperatures, they're very warm throughout the spring, summer. We don't really have seasonal changes. It's quite hot for 8 to 9 months of the year, and we have a very, very small, short, intense winter. And I'd say intense because we have 2 to 3 weeks where it's really, really cold, and the rest of the winter, it isn't really cold. It's bearable. You can get away with wearing a long-sleeved tee with a cardigan over, but it's not really cold. So the changes in temperature are exactly what we're looking for. That is one of the reasons why we chose that area to go and live in, because there's such beautiful seasons, and autumn is just gorgeous in the mountains with the changing of the leaves. In the area where we currently live, the indigenous plants are evergreen. So throughout the year you have green trees. They don't lose their leaves for the most part in the winter. So I was looking through a lot of my clothing because I took one pair of trainers going to the mountains and I took a pair of brogues, and both pairs of shoes were very light in color. And we went for a walk along a mountain path in my Veya sneakers. Was that not very unwise of me? But I came back with these filthy, dirty sneakers that I had to literally wash, and I didn't know how the leather was going to hold up in the wash, so I washed them by hand, and they have come out quite clean. I never ended up wearing the brogues because of the mud, and I just thought I'm going to have one pair of shoes that I'm going to have to clean when I get home. I'm not going to clean another pair of leather shoes. So I realized that my wardrobe is going to change for the most part. I'm going to be doing a lot more gardening, so I'm going to need gardening clothes. And I was going through my Instagram page and thinking that although I have a very casual style, I love whites and I love light colors, and that's not going to work in the mountains. Of course there are days that we're going to go shopping and that we're going to go out for lunch where I will be able to wear them, but for the most part I'm going to need to change my wardrobe big time. We are going to be living in a very farmland kind of environment. Most of the roads are not tarred. That's going to take some getting used to. Luckily my husband and I both drive 4x4s, so on that front we are sorted. But my closet is going to need some serious upgrading or downgrading, however you look at it. Both my husband and I are not really very outdoorsy people, so we don't have clothes that are really made for different kinds of weather. If it rains where we live, we just don't go out. It's not like in the northern hemisphere where rain is so much a part of your life that if you didn't go out, you would never go out if it rained. Here we have days of rain that happen during the summer months, and you'll have one or two days of rain, or you'll have what we often call the afternoon showers. So you've had your whole day, you've been able to go out, and you don't need an umbrella, you don't need a raincoat, you don't need a trench coat, you don't need wellies where we live, because generally you can do what you need to do without getting wet. You can go to the mall, you can park underground even if it rains, and you can do everything that you need to do without worrying about getting wet. I do not own a raincoat. I think that where those things are concerned, I'm going to need to change my wardrobe. So I was looking online and I saw this raincoat, and I am so interested in looking for a secondhand trench as well. I think that both of those are going to really be helpful in my new lifestyle. I don't want to have to stay indoors just because it rains. I don't want to be one of those people who let the weather dictate what I can and can't do. I want to be able to adjust to this new lifestyle, and I want to be able to enjoy it as fully as I possibly can. I am going to invest in a pair of wellies. I do not have anything like that at the moment. A lot of my shoes are leather. I think leather can be used obviously in the winter months. You just have to take care of it. But I do have a lot of suede shoes. I'm not getting rid of shoes. I've made a decision that I love all my shoes. I do have about 70 pairs of shoes, which is way too much. I do understand that. But I've decided that in time I'm going to replace shoes with those that will be more suited for my new lifestyle. So I've had an eye on these wellies, and I'm going to look for a pair of these in South Africa that will work for my new lifestyle. If you follow me on Instagram, you'll know the dilemma of my daughter's cat, who is currently staying with us. So if you hear him meowing in the background, that is definitely him. He's competing with me. Django! I'm just going to sort him out and then I'll be back. Another thing that my husband and I definitely want to do is we want to start hiking. There are beautiful trails in the mountains. I do have a pair of hiking boots that my cousin gave me. They are Merrell's, so they are a good brand, but I think that I'm going to invest in another pair. So I've been looking around and this is what I came up with. I am not going to buy them immediately. I'm going to use what I have and see how far I get with that, if one pair is definitely going to be enough. But should I need another pair, I'm definitely going to invest in something that is going to give me many years of wear. I also need to invest in darker sneakers. I do have a pair of black Vans, but they are suede, so they are not going to be the best option for outdoor wear when we move. So I have been looking at some Adidas sneakers and a pair of Reeboks. So I'm going to pop a picture of the ones that I have been looking at over here. Again, I'm not going to just buy before I move. I'm going to wait until I'm settled and see from that aspect and from that point of view what it is that I really need. I have been looking in my wardrobe and looking at gaps in my wardrobe and thinking that these are the things that I will need to add. But once I'm there, I might find that I can do with what I already own. One thing for sure is that I'm going to get more wear out of my lightweight jackets. So things like my denim jacket, which I hardly ever wear here in Pretoria. I'm thinking that all those third layers, like blazers and jackets, like all weather jackets that I bought for different trips and different holidays, I'm now going to be able to bring to the fore and I'm going to be able to wear them. So I'll pop a picture up here of me in my denim jackets, and I'm quite excited to be able to just take it with. Even if I don't wear it for the whole outing, if we go somewhere, it's nice to be able to take something extra with. It is likely that I'm going to need it at a point of time in the day. I have, as I said, a lot of light pants. I have about 5 to 7 pairs of white trousers. I'm sure I have 7 pairs of white trousers. And I also have a lot of neutrals, so a lot of this kind of clothing. And I don't think that I'm going to be needing that there. I think I'm going to wear more darker colors. It's not that I'm going to get rid of any of the lighter colors, at least not yet. But as I go along, just as I do now, and I don't wear clothes for extended periods of time, because we are going to live there, because this is where we want to spend the rest of our days in South Africa, I think that it's great if I start to alter my wardrobe now. So this little video was a little bit all over the place. I'm just sharing a few of the things that I feel that are going to definitely change, that I think right now are definitely going to change. I was going to do a little bit of a home tour because I've never showed you my home, and I wasn't sure if that was something that you would be interested in, because I haven't really done home content on this channel. There are a lot of rooms now. There's about 3 rooms in my home that is completely empty. My granddaughter's bedroom is emptied. My daughter's bedroom is emptied because obviously they've moved out. They moved out this past weekend. If you would like to see the house, obviously there will be empty rooms. It won't look like it looked when we lived in it. We have lived here for 10 years on Saturday, the 31st of October. And we've been very happy here for those 10 years. We've had ups and downs, but this is the place that we blended our family. This is the place that we became one family. And although we're sad to be leaving this house and all the memories that we have from this home, which we will still carry in our hearts, we are so ready for the next step. Should you want to see our home, I'm more than willing to do a little home tour in the future. So let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching this higgledy piggledy video, and I will be back to normal content next week. I will be doing fashion again. I couldn't film last week because we were away. My filming day is usually on a Thursday, and I wasn't able to film because we were away. And with the move, helping my daughter move this weekend, it just was quite impossible to get anything done. Today is Tuesday, tomorrow is Wednesday. This video needs to get up and I need to edit it. So I need to get my butt into gear. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.